Hey, there's a big long line of people waiting out there. Get all the bugs off. Look at this grill. We're getting charged by the minute.
We're literally going to get a buggy tomorrow.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
What do you guys think? Fan, what do you think? Pretty incredible, huh? Eamon, you're doing what? Taking your picture of Fluffy?
Yeah,
in every place in the United States.
I love it.
All right, so we went up to the main entrance and the guy came out. I said, hey, you guys, we're just hoping that maybe you guys have a spot, maybe someone left. And he said, sorry, we're full. But would you be interested in staying in the overflow lot, which is out by the amphitheater here, for one night? And then get up in the morning, leave the RV there, the family sleeping. I get up at the crack of dawn, or before the crack of dawn, and come out and get in line. Because he said that it'll be sold out by 11, but there's some people leaving. So he said, if you get here early enough, and Monica's like, so 7? And he's like, 7 at the latest. And I said, how about like 5? Because...
Because we're gonna spend
like a week here, so let's make sure that we get a spot. So yeah. I'm gonna get up, 4:45 is the alarm, come down here, sit in the dark, clean water, see dump station. So we just dumped.
Are you gonna fill up our water?
I'm gonna fill up our water, so we have full tanks going into the camping.
All right.
And then we'll try to get a spot tomorrow for like, I don't know, a week?
Sure.
Why not?
So we're currently in parking in the amphitheater. The amphitheater is right over there, and there's a couple other people here in the overflow lot. So this is, and then there's the Tetons out there. Monica is super tired tonight. I think everyone is just wiped out. So I took the kids swimming, and we're gonna get the fishing license going and get them fishing. Monica's in bed in the RV. I'm gonna cook up some hamburgers on the grill, and then we're gonna call it a night, because I gotta get up, I don't know, I'm gonna get up about 5, because I want to get down there and I want to get in line. I don't want any of these other people taking our spots. But our plan from here was to go to Utah and to Bryce Canyon. But talking to some people from that had just come from there, they said it was like miserably hot, 105. And so we can stay here for up to 2 weeks. So we may very well stay here for 2 weeks, because this is a pretty awesome place. All right, so out from Jackson, I'll see you guys at 5:30 in the morning, maybe 6. Nah, 5:40. I'll see you at 5:40.
All right, so it is 5 a.m. on Friday, and I just got down here. There's one person in front of us. Someone just pulled in behind. I think those are gonna start filling up. The people here said, you know, try to get here by 7, but I wanna make sure we get a spot. So just gonna hang out here. I may sleep a little bit. I'm still a little tired, but otherwise just be hangout time. Campground update number 2. It is 6:52 in the morning. The sun has come up here. The office opens at 8, so we got one more hour, and there is a lineup of about, I'd say probably about 12 cars and RVs behind us, so happy to be here. We are number 2 in line, one person in front of us. So that is the lineup to get into the park. Goes all the way back. And it is 8 o'clock, the park just opened. There's a lineup about, gosh, it looks about 30, 40 deep now. They said that the longest line that they had was last week. It stretched for a mile down that main road. So we were here 3 hours, or I was here, 3 hours prior to that main office opening. And I was the second one to get a spot. We got a big spot right on the river, river views. So back to the campsite to hook up. See if the family's ready to head to our spot. We got it for 5 days. You can extend to up to 14 days. So you can stay in this site for 14 days. This is the, I butchered the name yesterday. I called it the Gros Ventre, which is not, it's French. It's like Gros Ventre. Anyway, it looks like that. We're in site 137, should be nice. Head back to the family. Enjoy some amazing time here in Jackson.
All right, guys, 8:45, everyone just got up. Everyone is well rested, ready to head over to our spot. Oh yeah.
There should be a rule about not filming before coffee.
We're checked in. Here it is. Nice spot. Right by this beautiful field. Hey bear. Remember, you're gonna make lots of noise. No, Ken, you're right. So here we are on the banks of the Gros Ventre River. Mommy is walking Fiona over. We're doing a little float day. What we've been doing is the kids would jump in here, we'd float down and get out there. And yesterday we jumped in here and the kids wanted to go down through this set of rapids here. Fiona got a little bit scared. So I stood up in the middle and I grabbed onto Fiona and I walked her over to the edge. However, if anyone's floating in the Gros Ventre River and you find a wedding ring.
A Celtic band.
You guys want to float?
Yeah. Mommy's number is 9715.
No,
that's a small.
Not ready. If we're gonna do the world's longest hammock, then we gotta document it.
You are.
Tell me what your goal is here.
Such a downer.
Tell me what your goal is here. Tell me what your goal is here. So we're gonna do a hammock from this tree over to this tree.
Yeah.
Okay. What about to the generator?
You tell a woman she can't, you know what she's gonna do?
I never said you can't.
Yeah, you did.
No, I didn't.
You literally said,
I said,
you can't do that. You can't do that.
I said, that's very ambitious. Mommy's.
So this is one of my favorite little RV hacks is the RVs are not known for having amazing cabinetry and they tend to chip and ding really easy, even really nice ones. I just think that the wear and tear on them is extraordinary and our kids just kind of thrash everything. And so what I found is I just get this little wood finish pen. You by all means do not have to use this pen. Back home before we left on our trip, I actually just used a black Sharpie and a brown Sharpie and mixed them together. And that's essentially what this pen is. This is a $10 Sharpie. So go out, get yourself a Sharpie. And you know, like Staples, they have all different color packs of Sharpies. They even have like skin color ones. So you can probably match your wood pretty easily. But if you can't and you have a unique color wood, this Minwax wood finish pen might just do the trick for you. What I like to do when I'm retouching a top of a door and I'm retouching like a good portion of it is I like to just get like a paper towel or napkin or something like that and just kind of rub it along the top and make sure that I'm not leaving any pen marks. Now, I wouldn't suggest doing something like this on an entire cabinet. You're really gonna see the pen marks. But like on the top of a cupboard or something like that, you should be fine.
What are your thoughts here as you approach your bucket list?
I'm so excited.
It is
12:30.
You know, I didn't put my watch on today because I thought, why?
Why?
Tuesday, August 4th.
Yes.
We're supposed to leave our campsite tomorrow. Fiona, are you ready to leave? No. She just gave us a no nod. None of the kids want to leave. We've been there for 5 days. We can stay up to 14. I feel like we haven't seen it all.
Yeah, no.
We're definitely going to
extend. Jackson, Wyoming is. So fun.
See this?
Yeah. What was that? Was that like a geyser?
Like through the roof.
Oh, that was, you know, the roof. In the...
But this is the roof.
Through it. Got it.
Okay, have you ever done this?
No.
It's like, this is the church. This is the steeple. Open the room. There's the people. Oh, it's that. That's
no,
right. This
it.
Is the church. That was the wrong way. This is
that
the church.
That was the dirty version. Church.
This is the steeple. Open the door.
And there are the people.
How do you do that? Okay, so one of the things that we wanted to do on this trip, you especially.
So the kids have their bucket list items. You kind of probably have yours. Yours is probably hiking.
Mine's really just every day I get to spend with my family and with you is a bucket list day.
That's so cheesy.
And seeing a grizzly. No.
My bucket list item was going on a horseback ride because I love horses.
Yes, you.
I absolutely love horses. I love animals of all kinds. So we booked a tour at, what's the name of the ranch?
Spring Creek Ranch, in the description.
Spring Creek Ranch. We booked a 2-hour tour. I don't know if this is like common, but we had just our 5 people in our family and our tour, our leader. So it was just us
and
her.
Yeah, it was great.
It was awesome. But our leader's name was Renata. Renata was a plus. Fiona was right behind her in line, and Fee is a total chit-chatter, and they chatted like nonstop the whole 2 hours. She is a wealth of knowledge. She's a college student here, mm-hmm. and she was just such a total sweetheart.
Yeah. So she had the 3 kids up front, and then mm-hmm. you and I were just in the back kicking it. So these horses were really well trained.
Yes.
There was no concern putting our kids on there at all.
No, I felt totally safe.
They require
helmets
under age 12, which they have there, and they sanitized everything, and it was all very well managed. It was a great top-notch operation.
With amazing views.
The views up on top of the vista.
I'm sure you could do this ride anywhere.
you know, as far as like there's other operations.
Right, you could do horse rides elsewhere.
But I like this operation because the trail that they took you on was just gorgeous.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It was totally worth money. Tip your leader when you
tip
get
your
done.
Leader, kiss your horse, and tip your guide.
That's right. That's what the sign
you
says.
You don't want to kiss your guide and tip your horse.
Yeah.
Get you wow. into a lot of hot water.
How long have you been thinking about that one?
It just came to me right now. Spring Creek Ranch, horseback riding. Hit it up.
Do you know what he said to me? He said, I think we're going to have to get some horses.
Horses are really fun, but they're a lot of work too. I know that.
Yeah, well, I'll do it.
So I'm going to be on the road. So if you guys want to mind shoeing my horse.
Well, they're kind of expensive, so you work and I'll take care of them.
All right.
Sound good?
All right.
Deal?
Deal. Beautiful spot. However, we don't have any services here. We have the generator running to give us electrical, but we don't have any water. We don't have a way to dump. We do have bathrooms right there with running water, so we don't need to use our black tank, which is great. I do need a way to fill up the water. And so I wanna show you what we've been using because these things are great. Smartbottleinc.com is the website. This is a 5-gallon foldable plastic water jug. And so what I do is I'm going to take two of these. So we go through about 12 and a half gallons a day right now. Just, you know, with showers and water needs. So this is potable water here, but I like to filter anyway. So we grab our... about 10 or 15 minutes a day. What's really nice about these is that they are super tough, tear resistant. You guys know that I could air violin. Yeah.
You can air anything.
That's true.
You can do anything.
And as we approach the top, I just want you to know that I love you a lot. Okay? You've always been my most favorite middle child.
I'm the only middle child.
Shh. If anything happens to me, I'm very proud of you, okay? I love you.
Are you?
I'm really, really scared of roller coasters.